Hello, my name is Derek, and I'll be giving a presentation over a beer data set. So let's get into it. So, looking at the data, we have a beer name, an alcohol by volume, an international bitterness unit, a brewery ID, a style, and a number of ounces for each beer. And that brewery ID is linked to a brewery name, a city, and a state. Now, let's look at the number of breweries in each state. As you can see from the heat map, there is generally a lot of breweries in states with high populations, although one sort of outlier is Colorado with the highest number of breweries. It's in the middle there. And I actually went to the Colorado School of Mines as an undergraduate and got this shirt from the Coors Factory in Golden, Colorado. Now, before we go any further, there is quite a few missing IBU values and a few missing ABV values from the beer data set. Everything else has no missing values. And what my partner and I did is, if we're looking at ABVs, we just removed all the beers without ABV values. If we're looking at ABV and IBU, then we removed beer data that is missing either. So now let's look at my favorite graphs in the whole presentation, which is the median ABV and IBU by state. If you look at the legends, you'll see for the ABV, the maximum number of beers is about 210, and the maximum number of IBU beers is about 130, which shows off what I showed in the previous slides, which is that there's a lot more missing IBU values. Another interesting insight is for the ABV, Colorado and Michigan, despite having a high number of beers, they are still on the left side of the chart, having high median ABVs. And for the IBUs, it's follows a more predictable pattern of the states with high number of beers tending to be in the middle and not having as extreme median values. Now, if we're just looking at the distribution of the ABV variable, we'll see that it has a pretty heavy right skew. The median is 5.6% ABV, and median is about 6%. Now, let's look at the highest ABV beer, which is the Lee Hill Series Volume 5 Belgian Style Quadruple Ale with a whopping 12.8% ABV. From the state of Colorado. The beer with the highest IBU is the Bitter Bitch Imperial IPA with a IBU of 138 from the state of Oregon. And the most average beer is the Harpoon IPA with a mean ABV of 5.9, IBU of 42, the most common style, which is the American IPA, and it is from the state of Maine. Now, there does seem to be a relationship between ABV and IBU given this chart. It seems as ABV increases, IBU increases, a plausible correlation. But what's interesting is it looks like it levels off and maybe even goes down after about 10%. There's not a lot of beers with an ABV above 10%, so it's hard to really know. It'd be really interesting to get more data on those higher ABV beers if they exist. But for now, we're going to move on and talk about the K&N classification model that we built to distinguish between IPAs and other types of ales using ABV and IBU to classify it. And we found with a K of 6 had the highest accuracy at 86.16%. And this next chart right here, I think, does a good job of explaining why we got the 86%. The other types of ales in the bluish green here tend to be on the bottom left of the chart, and IPAs tend to be clustered more in the top right, but there is still a lot of crossover. There's not very tight clustering, so we would expect accuracies around like 80-85%, which is what we got. Anywho, cheers. Thanks for listening to this presentation. If you want to see the code, there's a project linked here. And if you have any questions, please feel free to reach out to me. Thank you.